Do you want to know why you have intense anxiety on Sunday evenings? That's what this video is. So Sunday evening between 5:30 and 7, 8-ish, depending on when you're going to get up the next day, a lot of people talk about having this feeling of dread, this feeling of anxiety. Okay. Now, it's very, very common. Where does it come from? Can we ever move past it to a point where Sunday evening doesn't bother us anymore? The obvious thing to look at here first is, well, what's the next day? It's Monday. And if you're in a job that you don't like, you're not looking forward to going back to work, right? That's the obvious thing to say. But it's a funny thing because oftentimes people will talk about having this anxiety even during the holiday period or when they don't have to work on a Monday. Where is that coming from? The answer, guys, is programming or conditioning, right? So our whole lives, especially when we're young and we start going to school and we have that dread of going to school, the point here is that probably from the age of like 4, maybe all the way through your life, you've had this conditioning about Monday. Okay, Monday's coming again. I don't like going to school. It's boring. It's blah, blah, blah. It's hard work. So because of the judgment about Monday for so many years, it's kind of ingrained in us. It's this sense of tomorrow's Monday and this Sunday evening feeling kicks in. I experience this myself. The way I experience it sometimes is, I remember when I was going to school, there was this TV show. And it was always on a Sunday evening. It's called Heartbeat. And the theme music for that show was a Buddy Holly song, Heartbeat, right? So I'd remember watching that show when I was younger, and Sunday evening, my homework wasn't done. I wasn't ready for the week ahead. The sense of dread will be there. To this day, when I hear that song, I kind of feel those feelings again. Okay, so that's what I mean. It's conditioned response. So how can we move past it? Okay, the first thing, and it's a bigger issue, but it's to find that this does sound like it's a tall order here, but it's not a short-term fix. It's not a little gimmick, right? That feeling is telling us that we need to break out of our conditioned way of living. We need to stop doing the things that we felt like we had to do when we were younger. We need to start living independently, making choices on our own terms based on what we want. So that might be in terms of a career. Well, on Monday morning, am I going into a job that I hate? I'm not saying that you should quit your job because you don't feel good on Sunday evening. Not at all. But what I'm saying is it's an indication maybe that I'm not living my purpose. Okay, I'm not living my purpose. I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing. So then you use that emotion, and that emotion can kind of become a catalyst or a motivator for you to start questioning, why am I doing this? Okay, I don't feel good about this. I don't like this, but I'm doing it out of a sense of security or obligation that I might have. And then you start to think, okay, what can I do? How could I move out of this into something else when I'm ready? I'm making actually a strategic plan for that. Okay, I can work in this job that I don't particularly like for the next 6 months. And at that point, I'll be ready. And actually having a date in your mind sometimes can be really, really helpful. Okay, then it's time for me. I know that I'll move on at that point. And really make a promise to yourself. That can help too. And have a date in mind for when you're going to move on. And do the next thing. It's going to be scary too. If you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, right? It feels good for sure, but it's scary. It's scary too, right? Doing what you want to do and moving away from maybe security that you might have in place. So this, to recap on this, the Sunday evening fear that we have, this anxiety, is a conditioned response, but it's also a reminder or an educator that, okay, am I on course with my purpose? And I'm not saying to do anything rash here. I'm talking about being compassionate to ourselves here and figuring out, okay, this emotion is trying to tell me something. And can I figure out a way to, you know what to do next that will be in alignment with my purpose? that won't have me feeling these feelings, because I prefer not to feel these feelings. I prefer to feel more relaxed, more liberated, more independent, maybe, whatever it might be. So this is a big issue. If you'd like to talk about it, maybe if you're going through something like this anxiety or this sense that you're not on course with your purpose in life, contact me. The link I think is up here. I'm never pointed to the right area of the screen. Maybe this is the right one. Or the link is in the description below anyway, I think. And send me an email and I'll email you back and we can set up a free consultation to see if we're a good fit together and whether you would like to talk about this and how you can actually strategically move into something else. So guys, I appreciate you watching this video. Thank you so much. Maybe consider liking this video if you liked it and subscribing. It helps my channel here, helps me get these videos to more people. So have a great week. If you're watching this on Sunday, I hope you have a great week ahead, and hang in there, and I will talk to you again soon.